from like your very first show you guys played with W.A.S.P?
Awesome. There was no stopping us. We were insane. People were just, their jaws hit the floor every time.
Did you guys have the whole meat thing and the drinking blood? Was that all put together by the first show?
Yeah, a lot of Blackie's ideas, a lot of good ideas coming from that man.
Yeah.
You know, movies and different things, TV and shit. But he incorporated it into the stage, and boy, let me tell you, it worked. We had, I can't remember a show that we did that fire marshals weren't out there inspecting before we started the show.
Was he still lighting himself on fire at that point?
He never actually lit himself on fire. He did maybe a wristband or something that had a little bit of retardant on it. The thing that was pretty scary was when he'd reach back with that torch and he'd ignite that big sign that was right over my head, the sign that used to go over my head.
Oh, sure. You guys even had it in the video.
Holy shit. You talk about sunburn and feeling heat right away. I was crazy back then, so I didn't let it bother me that much. I knew how badass it looked, so I went right along with it. I was as crazy as anyone else out there, so it looked good, and it even got me going, you know, it got my blood boiling. So, what was your question?
Just, anything stand out from that very first show? Do you remember it,
Just the first shows were just absolutely awesome. They were unbeatable. There was nobody else in town that could touch us. We were just madmen, and it came across, and it worked great. And if nobody ever saw those live shows in L.A., they missed out, because it was never the same. Well, not just because I was out of the band, but mainly that was the start of it. Once members were changed and shit, and they had to go to different venues and stuff, there were, of course, restrictions, and, you know, so it changed. But those early shows in Los Angeles were top. If you didn't see one of those shows, you don't know what you were missing. Because we got away with murder in them early days. It was just crazy. Very, very exciting. Very exciting time.
And you guys are just sort of instantly popular? I mean, once you start playing shows?
I'll tell you what. I'm not going to say any dates because I'm not for sure, but the story is that we played around town about a year. We were together as a band about a year. W.A.S.P. existed about a year, and we got signed. That's kind of unheard of. I think it was 81 through 82 we played. By the beginning of 83, we were negotiating. We got signed. By 84, that album was out, and we were like, boom, we were gone.
And you guys are like one of the biggest bands on the strip too, right?
Oh, yeah. We packed everywhere we played. Us and Crue.
Was there ever a W.A.S.P. and Motley Crue show back then?
No. We were just two. I don't think that ever happened, no. I would remember that because I was pretty good friends with Nick and Tom. I knew everyone back then. Just didn't hang out a lot.
You got any good Nikki or Tommy stories?
Yeah, but let's pass on that. It usually involves some kind of sexual deviancy or something going on.
Oh, man, you sure?
Yeah. The 80s were crazy, dude. It'll never be that way again. Beatlemania or whatever, yeah, but the 80s in Hollywood, something else. Debauchery, they'll never be that way again. Thank God. I lived through it.